Here's your host, Alex Garrett.
While I have a few minutes here, I just want to say, it looks like New York City is coming back. Did you know, according to the New York City Economic Development Corporation, there is a 64.4% rate of office visitation in Q2, up 5.4 percent points from the prior quarter. It's a post-pandemic record. And furthermore, it means things are coming back. Now, the city reached 50% of its pre-pandemic in-office levels for the first time in early June, according to Cranes. But when you look at the numbers being crunched, it looks to me like things are coming back. The city's office occupancy clocked in at 51.4% for a 7-day period ending November 29th, up 2.4% from the week prior. So we're getting some different levels here. We're getting some different metrics, which is promising. It shows New York City is coming back. But what will it take to get 100% everything? What will it take? I gotta know. What's it gonna take to get us at 100% level? Will it be a reduction in crime? Will it be the media reporting good stories about the cops even? Will it be, I don't know, just some damn good news? I get Mayor Adams' frustration, but he's at 28% approval rating for a reason. I hate to say that. But I get his frustration that the media doesn't paint the best picture of New York. But when you cut budgets of the NYPD, especially... that does scare people from coming back full time. That does. But guess what? We can overcome that. As a city and as a state, we can overcome that. We can say, hey, look at the numbers that we're getting, and let's build off that. And then let's reduce the cuts. Let's bring back a better force that can truly protect our city from even, yes, emotionally disturbed people. Let's fix bail reform so that, yes, we can have people locked up who deserve to be locked up and not released day of or even moments after. So I get where Mayor Adams is coming from. The city is coming back. I saw it today. Rollerblading. I had to really breeze through, as I was telling one of my radio colleagues, breeze through traffic, foot traffic, that is. Because it was getting crowded. And we love crowded. We need crowds. This economy is thirsting for true rebound. It really is. But I want to see more Courier and Ives kind of pictures with wreaths and trees and offices that people can actually enjoy because they're back in the office spending Christmas time and the holiday season back where they should be in New York City. That's what I want to see. And I think you should too. But if we're going to keep reporting on how bad it is, let's also acknowledge how great it is that there is a comeback abrew. Comeback afoot here in New York. Is there not? The approval rating is totally because of this FBI situation, which nobody seems to understand might actually be retaliation for Adams speaking out against Biden's lack of help when it comes to the migrant crisis. You have to put two and two together, people. You have to put two and two together. You can't just disapprove of a mayor because of the policy, and also because of the scandal, when you don't even maybe recognize that he has been advocating for support from the federal government for a long time. And the liaison from the White House, Biden couldn't even give his own time. He had to put a liaison. And that liaison has failed also. It's clear he's failed. Can we just say that? And so when Adams tells the city, hey, we're kind of stuck with this and whatever, that's not good. His defensiveness might rub people the wrong way and not acknowledging the real issues here. But at the end of the day, it's what we see. And maybe what you see too. Email me, alex@alexgnyc.com. If you're a city resident, are you seeing what I'm seeing, which was an uptick, especially on this Thursday, December 14th, an uptick on people coming from New Jersey on the PATH train, people coming off the subways in New York City to downtown Manhattan. That's what I saw. The crowds keep building. The question is, can we get to the point where Monday and Friday have people here too? That's the next big test. That would put us over 70%. I believe. Now if we get over 70%, will we shoot off fireworks again like we did with, like Governor Cuomo did with the whole vaccination process? I hope not. I think that was a little much. But it would be nice to see 70% again or more back in the offices of New York City. It really would. It really would. And so I just want to say from my own perspective on a rollerblade in New York, I saw people today. I had to weave in and out of foot traffic, and that gives me hope this Christmas season. And that's a reason why I forge along, and I wrote about this on my WordPress. I forge along, and I'm uplifted to forge ahead this Christmas and Hanukkah season. Because yes, I've had a lot of loss in this year alone. But those who have gone before us would want us to forge ahead in their honor or for ourselves. And that's what we have to remember when we get down, when we think of those who aren't with us this holiday season, think that they would want us to keep going, to keep forging ahead as God continues to give us the day to make it right for the world and within our own lives, I wrote on my alexgnyc.com website. We have a lot of work to do to keep us from the dumps. We have to get Israeli hostages released. We have to pray Israel defeats Hamas this Hanukkah season. We have mouths to feed in New York, coats to donate, and so much more to do this Christmas season that's what we should be focused on. Not being down in the dumps and sad all of the time. Yes, we'll have our moments, but we also have the big apple to save. This holiday season, I believe, we have to work hard, love each other harder, and trust that God will put everything into place as it's supposed to be. For goodness sakes, the Son of the Father, Jesus Christ's birth, is being celebrated once again this month on December 25th. That should motivate us to work together, to work hard in honor of those who have gone before us, and personally, myself, not worry about loss that lies ahead. Sure, I am terrified of what lies ahead, but I also remember that Christ healed in the now. In the now. And that's what we have to worry about right now. Be anxious for nothing. And be excited that there are crowds of people again in New York City. The only question is, how do we keep it going into 2024 and beyond into the new year? And I think it's highlighting great, great records being broken again in this great city of New York. Office visitation hitting 64.4% of pre-pandemic levels. That's huge. That is huge. And I think we're going to see a lot more in the days to come. At least we pray so. God bless you this Christmas season, this holiday season, this Hanukkah season, Kwanzaa season. And may you too be uplifted to forge ahead in in honor of those who have gone before us, and in honor of those who are working to save the Big Apple. Because we're all in this together. Have a great day on the Alex Garrett Podcast Network.